éloigne ça. Tell me.
C'est que j'ai donc une raison à faire moi.
Ton humeur.
Ce sac à vin fait perdre mon temps.
bloody hell. Not good!
Thank you. What, a gold tooth? Not many folks with gold teeth. There's a barman right close by, at the Limping Dog Tavern. I'd hate to think he's been killed.
I found that bag sitting in the mud. Did you see? A gold tooth. I only know one man with a gold tooth. He lives with his daughter on the Rue de la Verrerie. Number 5.
Thank you. Gold tooth? Yeah, this front one right here. I'm damn proud of it. Real tooth got knocked out in a bar fight.
Ce sac à vin fait perdre mon temps.
Citoyen, la garde avec nous.
Jean. Word, brother.
Merci. Merci du fond du cœur. Merci. Merci du fond du cœur.
Mais enfin, ce n'est pas du tout ce que j'ai commandé.
Bella's father went out to make some purchases 3 days ago and never returned. The grandmother is always making lists of errands for him.
What am I to do? I can't sleep. I scarcely eat. My father has disappeared. He's easily recognized. Tall, has a gold front tooth. He can be rather strict, but he has my best interests at heart.
I'm the girl's grandmother, bless her heart. I'm too frail to run errands, so her father would do them. I'd given him a list and sent him out to buy some things. I don't remember everything that was on that list, but I did want some things from the merchant right down the street on Rue des Lombards. I'm the girl's grandmother, bless her heart. I'm too frail to run errands, so her father would do them. I'd given him a list and sent him out to buy some things.
Have you
Il ne reste plus grand chose à faire.
On serait revenu vivre à Paris.
A few days ago he came by, bought shoes and sundries. His next stop was a butcher's shop that he'd never visited before. Asked me where it was. He left his list behind.
Blow to the head. Fella came in here, I thought he was a customer. and he jumped me in my own shop. He was wearing a tradesman's coat and a three-corner hat. Oh, he had some kind of crazy accent. Scottish, maybe?
Je ne sais plus trop quoi penser. neige dans la face.
Went out to make some purchases 3 days ago and never returned.
The grandmother is always making lists of errands for him.
Yes, I turned him into mincemeat and he deserved it, old miser. I should have chopped you up into haggis as well.
Chopped him up, eh? Nasty business. Well, pick a weapon.
Having trouble? It's a tough one, isn't it?
Thank you.
La cocarde tricolore du président.
Diable, ce Bastille.
Jean-Baptiste Rotondeau escaped prison. Ever hear of him? He knows a few things about the assassins. It's likely he'll attempt to get to the Templars and tell him what he knows. Assassinate him before the National Guard can reach him. He's right down there, escaping through the sewers.
Vous n'êtes pas, c'est des trousseurs, pas vrai?
He might try to double back.
We'll never find the bastard in this rat's nest.
Be ready, or we'll come back.
You will!
stop for a moment.
I've heard you turn loyalist.
What have you? Qui a-t-il ce soir?
Oh, merci. Dieu vous le rendra. Oh, merci. Dieu vous le rendra.
Moi, c'est un peu d'esprit. Je joue pas, je...
Mais pourquoi fait-il ça?
Ce n'est pas possible.
Mais ce que vous dites, c'est pas moi.
Je parie qu'il a bu.
Oh!
Mais il est fou.
Merci. Merci du fond du cœur.
Thank you. What was that?
Il doit se passer quelque chose de plus banal.
Bonjour à vous.
Thank you.
Pensez-vous qu'il m'aurait envoyé une lettre? Qu'il m'aurait transmis une pente?
Come here, you!
Le prix n'est pas négociable.
I'm not gonna stand for this anymore.
So how are you gonna make up the balance?
Tuer quelqu'un! À l'aide! Au meurtre!
Au meurtre! Que quelqu'un appelle les gars! Il y a un tueur par ici!
Thank you.
Quelle quantité?
Non, le drone.
Ravi de vous voir.
Conscience, crois-moi.
Il va falloir t'y faire. Elles sont toutes comme ça.
Situation.
On envisage de déchaîner la violence dans toute la ville les nuits prochaines.
Redis-moi en face que tu ne peux rien y faire.
Parce que moi, je ne pourrai rien faire quand les frères d'Amusie viendront me voir. Est-ce une menace? Hey.
Tu penses me faire j'ai peur faim. Avec ces deux outres à vin?
Des tunes, Lieutenant Latouche.
Oh, I wouldn't do that. Look. Lovely, no? The good folk of Paris give more money to crippled beggars than whole ones. Le Roi des Tunes sees in that bit of trivia, an opportunity to motivate his less successful employees.
That man
has lost a foot. Now you can charge in there, cause a great disturbance, and send all the rats scurrying back to their holes. Or you can disappear into the swarm and follow the rats back to their king. Either way, that man has lost a foot.
It's done.
Take him to the clinic for a proper cauterization, then send him back to the street.
Come on, up you get.
I appreciate the advice. Not yet.
Who are you, precisely? And why help me?
Oh, I've had my eye on you for some time now, Arno. I feel it my sovereign duty to aid all those who suffered in cruelest bondage with me at the Bastille. And I have a vested interest in seeing the King of Rats caught in a trap. As to my name, I have the pleasure of being Donatien Alphonse François, Marquis de Sand. Do pay me a visit when you've tired of chasing vermin. Oh, he's left a lovely trail. Good luck.
You'll be as warm as a baby in arms.
Les murs.
want some fun? I'll have a cut here and there.
Get him inside, quickly. Something doesn't feel right.
He's dead, sir.
Then toss him in the gutter and get yourselves inside.
Unfortunate in bed six.
Horribly burned in a fire that killed his family and drove him
away. A burn job? Do you know how hard those are to get right without burning half the district to ash?
Use a few drops of the strong acid. Layman can't tell the difference.
what they tune, and I'll spare you your life.
The catacombs! He's in the catacombs beneath the old church!
Latouche, I expected a stronger spine than yours. What will your master say?
Oh, God. God help me.
Monsieur, soyez le bienvenu.
Piss off, you lot.
Oh!
That should smoke them out. More of these Gracie's special projects on the streets these days.
Scares me every damn day all week. How the hell can I compete with triple amputees? You wouldn't do better or dismiss another tribute.
And you'll be remembering your own brave service.
Your old ideas and moderation will get you killed.
Citizen! You there!
Rioting all throughout the district. You men, with me.
I've heard reliable reports that an assassin is nearby and that you are his intended target.
The worm has grown a spine. Now he's a snake.
Damn. It was only a matter of time I knew that much. This is far too soon.
Oh, oui, my lord. The assassins are well connected.
But we have the advantage now, don't we? Muster the guard and lead the hunt for this assassin. Bring me his head.
But my lord, our men are all dealing with uprisings from the beggars.
You men, with me. Find them.
Embarrassing. Diable.
Perhaps not as clever as you think. So it is down to the two of us, assassin. Assassin.
You won't bloody lose me! Ah.
My subjects have eyes everywhere, my lord. I offer their knowledge to the service of the Order.
What knowledge could a King of the Gutters offer us? The intrigues of rats. You may go.
The intrigues of rats? Pompous fool, if I could lay my hands on him.
My master would be pleased to arrange that. Brother.
You're right, monsieur. Too much of the King's champagne.
Sibir, come away!
Done. Delacer is dead, Grandmaster.
Good.
Torches!
Ah, you're just in time for the commencement of my reign.
Your reign?
As long as there's a Cour des Miracles, we must have a Roi des Thunes. And since there seemed to be a vacancy, I stepped in.
With remarkable speed, the body's not yet cold.
I may have set things in motion a trifle early. Say, when you first arrived at La Cour des Miracles...
You used me.
Your target is dead. We used one another.
Quite a kingdom you've inherited.
It is, isn't it? So, is justice served? Are the dead avenged? Is your soul soothed, all that rot?
Rot is a fine description. Every time I think I'm getting close to the truth, it seems another layer of filth presents itself.
Conspiracy, intrigue, a rapidly thickening plot. Add some bestiality and a lecherous priest, and I say you have the beginnings of a beautiful novel.
I'd settle for a solid lead.
So young, and yet so serious. Well, best of luck to you. You have, I trust, looked into this.
Where did you get that?
One of my newly loyal subjects brought it to me as a token of esteem, as it were. It's a curious piece. I know of only one silversmith who works metal like this.
A blade of this make killed Monsieur de la Serre. I can only assume you knew this already. Why didn't you say?
Well, where would man be if he never had to ask questions? If everything he could ever want to know was simply handed to him, he might no longer think to ask questions.
Or he might accomplish a great deal more unburdened by ignorance.
Perhaps. The smith's name is François Thomas Germain. You'll find his shop near Les Halles.
Thank you.
Bonne chance.
cette entité? Non, le drone, c'est pas négociable.
Full purse again.
Ah, my friend. Hello.
You look terrible.
For months, I have been wrangling the Brotherhood, the National Assembly, and the King. Taken all together, they have the political acumen of an especially stupid village council. I believe that excuses my appearance, young man.
I meant no disrespect, Mentor. I'm only concerned.
Forget me, Arno. Weep for France. But enough politics. I hope you have happier news. What of Lord de Lassalle's murderers?
The King of Beggars is dead. He was carrying this.
A posant pay. You should keep it. It'll do no one any good moldering in a forgotten crypt. Carry it with honor.
Thank you. I will.
The mission.
The King of Beggars and Sivert were only pawns in a larger game. Someone sent them after Monsieur de Lassalle.
Templars do nothing simply, do they? Do you have anything solid on this mysterious chess player?
The only lead I have is the instrument that killed de Lassalle, a pin fashioned by a silversmith named Germain. But how he's involved, I can't yet say.
It seems your course is clear. Find the silversmith, learn what part he plays.
How are you, friend?
care to step into the ring.
Oh, Arno. Paris. Oh, Arno. What have you done? I know we didn't part on the best of terms, but to go running to the assassins? My father kept you away from them for a reason. Their creed is like wine, sweet enough at first blush, and in moderation it makes life seem more bearable. But drink too deeply, and you find naught but madness and anarchy. No doubt they've already filled your mind with tales of how dreadful we Templars are, that we would make slaves of humanity, and place our boots on the world's neck. You knew my father, and you know me. I can only pray that is enough to give the lie to those tales. My order has turned against me, and I am hunted by those I once called friend. I could not bear it if you turned against me also. Think of me, and be well, Elise. Oh, Arno.
Arno and Elise.
Distrayant.
exactly are you accusing me?
I'm not sure, sir. Answer the bloody question.
You look like
I am.
This is my patriotic duty! Don't make me suffer for that!